In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a cool slow motion effect where time is based on your character's speed. So if you're moving, then time will move, but if you're standing still, time will be really, really slow. Here's how it looks like. Let's see how we can build this. Start off by creating a new project and selecting the first person template. And before we actually start using blueprints, you need to know about a command called slow-mo. Run the game, press the tilde key to bring up the console, and type in slow-mo 0.5. This will make the game go at half speed. Same works for a value above 1, for example 4. As you can see, the game is going 4 times faster than normal. This is the command that we'll be using to change the speed of the game during gameplay. So, first thing you need to do is find the first person character blueprint, which is in first person BP blueprints first person character. Double click it to edit it, and let's right click on an empty space and find the tick command. This is perfect for us because, as you can see, this event is called every frame, and that's what we need to do. At every frame, we need to call the console command called slow-mo and change its value to our character's speed. So let's right click and type in execute. This will help us find this command, execute console command. Now, whatever we type in here is as if you typed it directly into the console. Drag off a pin from command and type in build string from float. This node is very handy because it lets us just plug in a float value and have a prefix. So as a prefix, we're going to have slow-mo spacebar. As a value, for now, we'll just try 0.5. If we drag off a pin to actually call this command and test it out, as you can see, the game is going at half speed. This is cool, but we need to change this value based on the character speed. Right click in an empty space and type in get velocity. This gets our character's velocity. As you can see, it's a vector. What we need is a float. That's easy to do. A vector has a function for you called vector length. This returns a float. This is a bit more useful, but if I plug this in directly, the game will go nuts because this value is not from 0 to 1. It's from 0 to your character's max speed. You can find the max speed if you click on the character movement component. As you can see, at the moment this is 600. So if I run this, the game's speed will be at 600 at one moment, which is not what we want. So let's break this. And let's map this to a bit more useful range. So right click and find map range. So our in range is from 0 to 600. And our out range is from 0 to 1. Now, whatever this value is, the output will be always between 0 and 1, as long as the input is between 0 and 600. Now, if we plug this in here and run the game, you will notice that when I move, the game looks fine. But if I stand still, the time slows down a lot. Enjoy.